Hello and welcome to In Depth. I'm Teena Jha. India's first 100% organic state, Sikkim, has won the Oscar for Best Policies, conferred by the Food and Agriculture Organization for the world's best policies promoting agroecological and sustainable food systems. Sikkim beat 51 nominations from 25 different countries of the world to win the Future Policy Award 2018. The Chief Minister of Sikkim, Pawan Kumar Chamling, received the award from the Deputy Director of United Nations FAO, Maria Helena Semedo, in Rome on the 15th of October. In 2003, Sikkim became the first state in India to officially announce adoption of organic farming to ensure long-term sustenance of soil fertility, protection of environment and ecology, healthy living, and decreasing the risk of health ailments. It also stopped imports of chemical fertilizers in the state, and since then, the cultivable land there is practically organic, and farmers of Sikkim are traditional users of organic manure. The Future Policy Award recognized the state's leadership and political will to lead by example. Today's In-Depth talks about the policies adopted by Sikkim that helped it become the first organic state in the world, the status of organic farming in India, and its potential in our agro-driven economy. Back in 2003, Sikkim officially took the decision to go organic. In the coming years, Sikkim made a transformational shift from using chemicals and pesticides to imposing a complete ban on them. In January 2016, Prime Minister Narendra Modi declared Sikkim as India's first fully organic state. And now, the efforts of the northeastern state towards achieving sustainable goals have been rewarded by the United Nations. The state has been awarded with Oscar for Best Policies Award.
Nestled in the lap of the Himalayas, Sikkim became India's first 100% organic state in January 2016, showing the way to other states and even other countries to turn organic with its no chemical pesticides, fertilizers and GMOs policy. In 2.5 years, Sikkim has now been recognized as the first organic state in the world by none other than the United Nations. The northeastern state has won the Oscar for Best Policies conferred by the Food and Agriculture Organization for promoting agroecological and sustainable food systems. Sikkim beat 51 other nominees from 25 countries to win the Future Policy Award 2018. A state by the UN body said, Sikkim is the first organic state in the world. All of its farmland is certified organic. At the same time, Sikkim's approach reaches beyond organic production and has proven truly transformational for the state and its citizens. Sikkim sets an excellent example of how other Indian states and countries worldwide can successfully upscale agroecology.
Sikkim state has taken major step declaring the state as organic state. So therefore, this is a big achievement for the state as well as for the farmers, because they are growing all products in a natural way, which are safe, good to eat, and there is demand. So definitely it is going to contribute to the sustainability of the agriculture in the state as well as improve the or increase the income of farmer in the state. So this is a significant achievement by the state and which has been recognized internationally.
Receiving the award at a ceremony in Rome on Monday, Sikkim Chief Minister Pawan Chamling said it took Sikkim over a decade to transform into a fully organic state. Citing the state's example, he asserted that a 100% organic world is possible. He also appealed for ending the use of chemical fertilizers globally by over 50% immediately. In 2003, Sikkim officially adopted a resolution to switch to organic farming. The state decided to go organic to ensure long-term sustenance of soil fertility, protection of environment and ecology, healthy living, and decreasing the risk of disease. The policy implemented a phase-out of chemical fertilizers and pesticides and soon achieved a total ban on the sale and use of chemical pesticides in the state. The same year, Sikkim also stopped all imports of chemical fertilizers. Since then, the farmers of the state have been using organic manure. In 2010, the state government launched the Sikkim Organic Mission to fast-track its journey towards achieving the 100% organic tag. The mission helped by providing seeds and manure and training farmers in organic methods.
Level of state government, there is a significant policy shift. And that policy shift for promotion of organic farming, that is one. Second, declaring the state as organic, that no synthetic input will be allowed there. So the state government has to provide necessary infrastructure facilities, train the farmers in terms of following the farm practices which are consistent with the organic. And second important thing which the government has to do, both central as well as state government, it is basically strengthening the marketing system, because these organic products, they have to be identified in the market that these are organically produced products, so the consumers, they can buy them.
The transition to an organic state has benefited over 66,000 farming families in the state, while also bringing about rural development and sustainable living. Besides proving transformational for public health and environment in the region, organic farming is also attracting a large number of tourists to the state, who throng to see its lush green farms, pure and organic agro products, and meals made out of fresh produce. Between 2015 and 2017, the number of tourists in Sikkim went up by 50%. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Organic agriculture uses naturally occurring substances for farming while prohibiting or strictly limiting synthetic substances. This enhances agro-ecosystem health, including biodiversity, biological cycles, and soil biological activity. A look at what is organic farming and why it is the need of the hour.
Organic farming uses techniques to achieve good crop yields without harming the natural environment or the people who live and work in it. It relies on organic or natural fertilizers like compost manure, green manure,
according
and bone meal,
organic,
and places emphasis on techniques like crop
India
rotation and companion planting. Biological pest control, mixed cropping, and nurturing insect predators are encouraged in organic farming. While all traditional farming is now considered to be organic farming, an organic movement started in the 1940s as a reaction to agriculture's growing reliance on synthetic fertilizers and pesticides. Lord Walter James Northburn coined the term organic farming in his book Look to the Land, which was published in 1940.
The organic farming is, it's totally banned the use of synthetic inputs. There, generally, we talk to two inputs. One is the synthetic fertilizer, chemical fertilizer, urea, all those things. And second is the this pesticide, chemical pesticide. These are totally banned. And even growth hormones, no? I mean, plant growth regulators, which generally farmers use, not that much in the northeast region, but some farmers, they use it. So these are totally banned there. And there are certain standards which the farmers, they have to follow. So that basically form the basis of the organic agriculture. There, it's again in terms of manure. So there are other kinds of manure which the farmers have to use. Compost, vermicompost, those kind of thing they have to maintain the soil fertility. Similarly, for this plant protection, basically, managing the pest, it's farm practices, cropping systems, how you, when you plant, when you harvest, what kind of, let's say, the other things you use for control of pest. So those are all organically or on farm naturally produced product which are used in the organic farming.
Key characteristics of organic agriculture include protecting long-term fertility of soils by maintaining organic matter levels and encouraging soil biological activity, providing crop nutrients indirectly using insoluble nutrient sources by the action of soil microorganisms, nitrogen self-sufficiency through the use of legumes and biological nitrogen fixation, and effective recycling of organic materials including crop residue and livestock manures, weed, disease and pest control by crop rotation, natural predators, organic manuring and minimal biological and chemical intervention, management of livestock paying attention to their evolutionary adaptations, behavioral needs and animal welfare issues with respect to nutrition, housing, health, breeding and rearing, and careful attention to the impact of the farming system on the wider environment and conservation of wildlife and natural habitats. Maintaining a green environment is a great concern worldwide, and organic farming can partly offer a solution as it promotes ecological harmony, biodiversity and biological cycles that are vital for environmental sustainability. Reckless use of chemicals in agriculture severely affects the health of people who consume end products and also those involved in such farming methods. Organic produce offers the safest products for human consumption as they contain lower levels of chemicals.
This is arising, one, because there is a demand for the products from the consumers, those who can pay more, and second, because it protects the environment. So because of these two reasons, so there is a demand, and there are advantages because in those regions where we don't have much high use of outside purchased input, chemical inputs. So those regions, they have advantage. They are following the organic farming or organic agriculture.
Latest data suggests 57.8 million hectares are available worldwide for organic farming, which is 1.2% of the world's agricultural land. Oceania, with 27.3 million hectares, has the largest area of organic agricultural land, followed by Europe, Latin America, Asia, North America and Africa. Worldwide, organic farmland increased by 7.5 million hectares in 2016, which is a growth of 15%. With 1.49 million hectares of organic land, India was placed at number 9 in the list of top 10 countries with the largest area of organic land in 2016. India also added an additional 0.3 million hectares to its existing organic land in the same year. With 178 countries involved in organic farming, the global market for organic food reached $89.7 billion in 2016 and is expected to grow exponentially in the coming years. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
India's progress in the organic sector has been remarkable. In the 1990s, the sector was limited to the export of tea to European markets. At present, India is emerging as a key player in the global arena, exporting over 300 products in 20 different categories to more than 20 countries. Besides, India is also the largest exporter of organic cotton and houses the largest number of organic producers in the world. The domestic organic markets are growing at a rate higher than the global average and are expected to keep growing at 25% by the year 2020.
According to the World of Organic Agriculture Report 2018, India has the largest number of organic producers in the world. With 8,35,000 certified organic producers, India is home to over 30% of the total organic producers worldwide. Experts say the increase in organic production is the result of a large number of entrepreneurs advocating organic farming and its complementary methods. At present, multiple organizations and firms are backing organic farming more than ever, spreading the impact of organic farming to common households everywhere.
Anybody can follow it, basically. There is no specific size, let's say the earmark for that, so only large farmers can do. Anybody can follow it. Only thing, in some areas, let's say where there is little slope, again you can say the hill, so in a particular landscape, all the farmers, they have to follow. If the farmers on the, let's say, lower side, they are following, on the upper side they are not following, and during the rainy season they are using let's say the chemicals or the chemical fertilizer, so that may be coming down, so that may disturb the whole thing.
However, when it comes to the area under certified organic cultivation, India contributes only 2.59%, That is 1.5 million hectares of the total area of 57.8 million hectares. But amongst regions with the largest areas of organically managed agricultural land, India ranks 9th, occupying a robust position in producing organic products. According to a report by ASSOCHAM and Ernst & Young, India exported 1.35 million metric tons of certified organic food products worth 1,937 crore rupees in 2015-16. India is the largest exporter of organic cotton worldwide. In the food market segment, oilseeds comprised half of India's overall organic food export, followed by processed food products at 25%. The current Indian organic market is estimated at 4,000 crore rupees and is likely to increase to 10,000 to 12,000 crore rupees by 2020, with a similar incremental trend in exports. The Indian organic market has been progressing steadily with a combined annual growth rate of 25% as compared to 16% global growth rates. But despite the promising performance in terms of exports, the local consumption of organic produce is still at a nascent stage with a market share of less than 1%. The current position of organic farming with reference to area covered across the country is 23.02 lakh hectares under the schemes Paramparagat Krishi Vikas Yojana, Mission Organic Value Chain Development for Northeastern Region and National Programme of Organic Production. Under the first two schemes, enough assistance is provided to farmer-producer companies, entrepreneurs for development of value chains and marketing of organic produce. The cost of organic agriculture largely depends on on-farm generation of inputs. When on-farm organic inputs are used, cost of production per unit area is less by 13% under organic agriculture than inorganic management. However, if organic inputs from outside the farm are purchased and utilized, the cost of production increases by about 15 to 20% depending on the nature of inputs used. Integrated organic farming system models being developed promise to meet 70 to 80% of organic inputs within the farm. This will reduce the market input cost considerably. Experts say the increasing support from the government has been the key driver for growth in the organic sector in India. Several other factors that contribute to the growth include increasing health awareness among people, rising disposable income, urbanization and working population, and technological developments. Innovative technological solutions using artificial intelligence, imaging and renewable energy, among others, are being developed by private companies for the organic food industry. Since the organic food segment is still at a nascent stage in India, both the government and private players need to develop a strong policy framework that can benefit all involved. The organic farming industry in India holds immense potential to grow, provided it receives steady investment and benefits from both existing and new initiatives like incentivizing organic cultivation, food processing, certification, and regulatory ease and tax benefits. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Well, organic farming may have gained momentum in recent years, but it has not yet managed to assume the center stage in Indian agriculture. Although several states have made remarkable progress in organic farming, it needs to overcome challenges at policy, commercial and infrastructural levels.
Organic farming is fast becoming the new face of Indian agriculture. The government has taken several steps to promote organic farming with the aim to improve soil fertility and help double farmers' income by the year 2022. However, despite developments in the field, it is surprising that organic farming has not yet managed to enter the agricultural mainstream. According to a 2017 survey-based study covering 418 organic farmers across different states in India, a move to organic farming methods may not be that easy and organic farmers are not getting the expected premium price for their produce. The study highlighted several key issues faced by organic farmers that are affecting their livelihood and income.
You have to prepare the farmers, because there are certain other areas where farmers they are following it, but you have to prepare. and there are standards laid out for this. When you have to shift from, let's say, natural farming to the organic farming, so there is a kind of this transition period. So certain practices you have to follow. Then you have to follow the other farm practices. Then you have to learn how to manage the pest, how to manage your soil fertility through organic way. So those are the things, challenges at the farm level.
One of the foremost challenges is the rampant use of pesticides and chemicals to get rid of weeds. Excessive use of chemicals have made pest and weed species immune to chemicals. This is the first hurdle in the transition from conventional farming to organic farming. Farmers also complain of low productivity during the transition from conventional chemical farming to organic farming. As organic farming prohibits the use of synthetic pesticides, the farmer is at the mercy of severe attacks from mutant pests. The situation becomes worse not only with the discovery of newer variants of pests and diseases, but also because of the traditional methods of pest control that fail to contain the damage to crops. This declines the overall production, hence farmers have demanded education and training on how to tackle pest attacks. Severe lack of suitable infrastructure is also proving to be a Herculean task for organic farmers. Maximum organic farming consists of fruit and vegetable production, which is highly perishable in nature. Inadequate agricultural infrastructure and cold storage facilities leads to loss of produce, mostly because of spoilage. An underdeveloped supply chain further affects small and mid-sized farmers that are located in hilly regions and tribal belts. Since organic products have to be stored separately from conventional products to avoid cross-contamination, the existing supply chain fails in this respect. After overcoming all these hurdles, when the organic produce reaches the markets, consumers find them expensive and hence they are discouraged from buying them. According to an ASSOCHAM study, 1200 to 1500 rupees per month is the additional expenditure if a consumer switches to organic food. Organic produce is more expensive due to higher labor costs and comparatively lower yields.
Then there is another major challenge, because the product has to be identified as the organically produced food, and there some kind of certification is required. So there are two kinds of certification. One is the farmers or group of farmers, or maybe some agencies, they can go for the self-certification. These are the product which are produced organically. That is one way. Second is the what we call the third party certification. So in third party certification, the other agencies, those who have capacity, they are trained and they can issue the certificate that these produced are organic produced. Because the basic condition of success is these produce, they must be identified in the market. As a consumer, if you go to the market, so we should be able to differentiate that this is coming through a natural agriculture, in traditional kind of thing, or maybe sometime we call it now the modern purchased input based, and this is coming from our this organic agriculture. So that differentiation has to be made in the market, then only consumers will be able to buy it. But once they identify, so they will have their own mechanisms to identify the organically produced, so the channel will be established. But initially it is the role of the, you can say, the government, farmers organizations and the agencies like EPIDA, they are also facilitate and these kind of developing the market channels and even promoting the export of organically produced products of agriculture.
Lack of an organic policy is one of the biggest challenges that farmers face in the domestic market. With no regulation on labeling standards for organic products and its logo, it becomes difficult to distinguish between an organic product and a conventional one. Even as farmers are struggling to find a better market, the existing certification systems for organic food too are making things difficult for them. The certification systems are cumbersome and time-consuming and also very expensive. However, the FSSAI is in the process of reviewing its regulations on organic food from July 1st this year after farmers raised these issues with them. With inputs from Leena Sharma, Bureau Report for Rajya Sabha TV.
And that's it from us in today's edition of In Depth. We'll be back same time tomorrow with a focus on some other important subject. You can also watch our episodes online on YouTube and Twitter and get back to us with your feedback and suggestions. Thanks for your time.